was changing my tefillin, fixing it. He doesn't know. And he made a mistake and he switched. Not allowed to wear it. You have to take it off.
You don't know.
You're supposed to take off. You're supposed to take off. Why? Because Chazal, understand this. Shulchan Aruch has the halacha. Rashi and Rabbi Nutan, they're like chol v'kodesh. It's like nothing to something.
Wow.
When coming to Rashi, Rashi tefillin is much higher. And you have to understand this. Although it's brought down that we don't understand reasons why. The Ben Ish Chai says people should wear Rabbi Nutan tefillin. Yes.
I don't have tefillin shel Rashi. I have tefillin shel Rabbeinu Tam. Should I wear it or not?
You should wear it. Of course you should wear it. You should. At least something. No bracha. No bracha. We don't make a bracha on this.
I went to the Bahamas.
I don't know where you
were.
You should wear it. You're not supposed to make a bracha. You put it down without the
bracha. Are you also feeling like that if you only have to remove
it? The person puts on tefillin Rabbeinu Tam is not your tefillin. The person who only puts it, at least he should do it. But Allah agrees, is not your tefillin because Allah is like Rashi.
For what they do it?
Why do you do it? Because it says, here's the thing. If somebody says, I put on tefillin today, and he did not put Rashi on, but he put Rabbeinu Tam, he did not put on tefillin.
So his question is, why should he put it on, he's saying? That's
why should you put it on?
Be honest.
I understand. No, it's not true. We don't understand. They don't understand. No, listen. There are shitot in Rishonim that they say, like for example, the Gaon Mevilna. The Gaon Mevilna had a big ta'ana. Listen to this. The Gaon Mevilna said like this. When they asked him, they asked the Gaon, why don't you wear tefillin Rabbeinu Tam? I told you two stories. First, I told you a story with Rabbi Yaakov Kamenetsky. Rabbi Yaakov Kamenetsky.
We don't have batim. I mean, you have only the klaf for Rabbeinu Rashi. Klaf shel Rashi for them.
You could. Why? Because you're going from Chol to Kodesh, Olim Bakodesh. You're allowed. I'm talking about the other way. From Rashi to Rabbeinu Tam, you're not allowed. From Rabbeinu Tam to Rashi, you could.
What were you saying, Rabbi?
If a person has tefillin Rabbeinu Tam and his tefillin Rashi, let's say, became no good, the smart thing to do is open the Rabbeinu Tam, take it out, put Rashi inside, and make it for Rashi now. That is most proper thing to do. But here's the story. They said that Rabbi Yaakov Kamenetsky, they came over and they said to him, Rabbi Yaakov, you don't have a dad. They asked him, Mipnema kvodolo mineach tefillin Rabbeinu Tam, how come you're not wearing tefillin Rabbeinu Tam? He said, they said to him, but Chafetz Chaim put on tefillin Rabbeinu Tam. You know what he said to them? He says, Chafetz Chaim put on tefillin Rabbeinu Tam when he was 90 years old. Begir tishim when he had tefillin Rabbeinu Tam. So listen to what he said to him. Rabbi Yaakov said to him, Kishani Gir tishim, I'm also going to put tefillin Rabbeinu Tam. Listen to the story.
What about Moshe Rabbeinu?
He asked him. He said to him, why don't you wear tefillin Rabbeinu Tam? He said to him,
I'm evita mashi sipru, but למה זה כל כך לא חשוב?
לא, זה חשוב.
לא חשוב, אם זה היה חשוב, הוא היה מלך את זה בגיל 20. לא בגיל 90.
I one time said to somebody, when I get to 90 years old, I'm also going to put it. Wow. I'm 90 years old, I have to put it. That's why they said about Rabbi Yaakov, they called him Emet Yaakov. By him, everything was so Emet. Rabbi Yaakov Kamenetsky was so Emet Yaakov. Because he said, I'm going to be, when I be 90 like the Chafetz Chaim, I'm also going to put it. And he zik
barab.
He
got
the sheep, who idiot.
Rabbi, what if we get the small one?
Okay, the story with small tefillin, I want to explain to you. A lot of problems.
When you get to 90, you put the tefillin, it's like, until 90, it's not important.
No,
The story with small tefillin. All those who want to wear small tefillin and want to order small tefillin, I tell you, watch out, because you have to be very careful, because a lot of times the letters are small, the clap is not such a, maybe in good quality, and the person writes it, the letters jump, sulim, and what not go on over there. Stay as much as possible as if you can away from it.
Those people,
unless you have somebody who's going to make it between Rashi and Rabbeinu Tam, he's a professional, and you know for sure it's going to be good. Because how many stories I know myself personally, when somebody opened it between those small things, they opened them up, took on the parshiyot, there was crap with almost nothing on it. Autiot polchot ba'avir.
No.
These letters fly. Trust the source. Now, the best thing is, all those people who do make such a tefillin, I advise them, don't make it too small. Why make it so small? So make it half the size. Don't make it three times smaller. Make it a little bit bigger. Don't worry, yesh makom bayad, yesh makom barosh, plenty of room. Don't make it too small. Don't make it too small. Also, a lot of people, they make the tefillin. So you have the small tefillin. Also, what you could do is, also what could be done is that tefillin could be made a little bit higher. Make it higher, make bigger parshiot, bigger klav, taller klav. No, not katanchik, not to make it too small. You have to be very careful. There's a lot of issues you should know. These parshiot, I explained to you something. This one is a big problem you have to realize. A smart sofer, when they make tefillin, if you go through it yourself, you open the parshiot, especially tefillin shel rosh, you will see some klav is thick, some klav is thin, some klav is very thin. Why?
Wouldn't fit.
The reason why, not because it wouldn't fit, because it's a hidu, la'alaha, you're supposed to make it at every parashia, when you roll it up, has the same thickness. So Shema Yisrael, there's very little to write the parasha, so they make thicker cloth. When the cloth is thicker, you have to realize something, you're making the parashat Kadeshli and parashat Ve'aya, they are long, they are very long. So you have to realize that you have so little room inside there. Ech machnisim is, how you put it in? So difficult, especially it's supposed to be gasot, has to be miksha, so many hidurim. If you're going so far, do it the right way.
Ahidov
shelo.